making a choice. Always have noticed when checking in my Twitter to see all that there's a toy in the game of the week. Maybe for pictures of it. In fact, the case is looking for some cards in the game to take on this one. So, 97 is United in the bright orange shirts, black shorts, orange socks will be kicking right to left to get us started, and then Toronto in the white shirts and black shorts, and the green sleeves will be kicking left to right to get us underway here. It's always the case that as the season advances with these divisions that the players will come and go as the university seasons ebb and flow, and that is the case this year, as the Toronto Nitro's goalkeeper Sierra Cotillane, who is back with the team and actually making her first start for Toronto, and that actually is where I'm going to start the starting lineup. This one is a loose ball. Loose ball from Sarah Owens, but she just about gets away with it. So the starting lineup for North Toronto, the visiting team, Sierra Cotillane. Number 3, Olivia McKinney. Number 4, Myra Webster. Number 5, Sarah Rollins. Number 6, Courtney Pugh, is going to be sat in that defensive midfield position. Number 7, Kiyomi McCausland, who's already off to a scoring start this season. Number 11, Elise Bell, the second highest scorer in the league thus far, with 5 on the season so far. Number 12, Alia Lucan. Number 15, Emma Warren. Number 16, Jesse DeBoer. And number 19, Isabella Mazzantaro, who is actually our leading scorer in the league throughout through the 4 games that they've played so far, as North Toronto make inroads into the Alliance penalty box early, as Lucan wants to jig her way through. And back to DeBoer, the captain. And then that ball Webster is safely touched by Roberta's bullets in the Alliance penalty. Goal, and she gives a great opportunity to then go through the starting lineup for Alliance. So number 3 is Beckett, number 4 Anna Chen, number 5 Valentina Greco, number 7 Anna Anderson, number 8 Chelsea Chung, who pitched in with 12 goals last year, so look for her to add some scoring clout. Number 9 Laura Grosser, who indeed was senior. 12 goals last year, and actually opened her account for this season just last week with an 88-minute winner over Unionville. So she's just kind of getting into her stride. Number 12, Miranda Badovinac. Sincere apologies. Number 13, Kristen Fox. Number 14, Holly Whelan. Number 15, Jennifer Wheeler. So as we settle into our rhythm here, we can see that North Toronto in possession, certainly playing with 3 out of the back as they ball forward and fought for by Emma Warren. This will get us restarted with the throw in from McCausland over on that far side. We're just a little bit loose, showing his alternate. So now we're going back. Searching for an outlet on the wing. Not quite accurate enough. It's an aggressive challenge for Toronto, holding the Alliance advance. Looking really good underway. Greco will hand the ball off. was good toss down behind as picked up by Crosser and she's set up to back against Webster. Again, it's making Webster too well. Maintaining body position and not allowing any avenue for the slick pass forward. Good turn. It's back on the way. Looking forward. That's a battle. A neat touch. For Lucan, perhaps asking a little much from the North Toronto wing back. As you can see, there is the racing track. We are actually in the University of Toronto Varsity Stadium, so there is a racing track around the stadium. So there may be some time spent on these restarts, but. Alliance, certainly some type of preferred throw in taker on this side, and you can see why. That's a good flight and good distance, so look for that to be a weapon later on for the throws of Hannah Chow. It's clear if Alliance are able to keep territory in the centre back. Looks to be a weapon with her throw in. We all know that one throw is, of course, can be a dangerous and tricky thing to manage for a defence. Looking for options. Chan waves it off. Decides to take it himself. There's a touch of physicality in the middle of the field, but getting away with it. Assessing her options, a lovely one from Matafero to chase. Just about dealt with by Chow, but it's Toronto consumer falling off, not necessarily pressing too hard early in this game. Giving the Alliance defense a little bit of time to settle themselves, but we'll also keep an eye on them and see if they ramp that up as the game moves on. You saw making this run down near the touchline, looking for that ball from Webster. Finish up this time. That one over for Bell to chase. Toronto perhaps needs to set themselves down. And Alliance not yet settling into a real pattern of play, of possessional play thus far. Or largely been at the feet of an North Toronto player until the first few minutes of the game. That one moving for Webster. She's not moving on this near side, she loves it. Able to turn. Oh, slides that one through for Lincoln. A nice aggressive touch from the wing back to get it into the space and claim that space for her own. Dealt with well by Valentina Greco, the Alliance left back. You may not have nothing but a corner, so it's always interesting for these set pieces, of course, to see how these teams line up. How they step up and shape up before they set to attack. So you can see that the North Toronto team have a small clump of players, and I'm sure they will look to break apart and confuse their markers as this ball is played in. Player on the line, so sort of obscure the goalkeeper. That's a barrel. Loop this one across. That's a barrel. It's taken down by the war. She's not able to make any sort of inroads. Not really kind of like even though. Alliance looking to transition. And a good turn from Gossa. Winning the free kick. Although in this instance, you have to say it was a good, an understandable foul from Mancini to give away. Great pressing from McCausland to win this ball high up. She takes that space, tries to get around her fullback there. Was looking for the intervention of the referee, but referee Dwight, he wasn't interested in the slightest. Deeming instead the play of one of the entirely lawful. Releasing a good ball for Bell to chase. A little bit too much on it, but it's got to be something I need to keep an eye on. North Toronto ability to settle on the ball quickly, turn, eat that ball in for the willing runners they have either side. This front four, of, including the two wingbacks, really look very, very happy to get forward and cause some trouble. To get that one moving, but now, as you've seen already, this is at least the second occasion that she's been able to jump into a challenge. Aggressive, stopping any further progress down this Alliance left side. This one nearly finding its way through for Gossa on the turn. Defending that, but we're able to move on without good play stopping. Oh, a lovely touch from Boo into the space beyond the player. Maybe caught two lines with her pass, but makes it through nonetheless. A good attempt from McCausland, well struck. And that is unfortunate from the Alliance keeper. Actually, she's done so well with the initial save. Nearly blundered her way into giving up the first goal of the game, but stuck with it, understood the danger that she had set for herself, and actually made the save on that affair as well. I'll go down as another save, but that's it. Came under her own steam in this instance. She has nowhere to go. That's nifty. It's nifty for the challenge from Anderson. Looking for the run of Holly Whelan, but a little bit ahead of her, snaffled up by the North Toronto defense. McCausland has her arm up. She wanted that ball over the top from Webster. I think, as mentioned again, I had mentioned a front four, maybe more of a front five, particularly when North Toronto were in possession. You can see them actually almost lining up the wingbacks. Here goes one of them. The wingbacks are the three forwards. Always willing to kind of take the space behind the defensive line as Greco again dawdles and nearly gets the ball away this time, but at least Bell looks to be keyed in on it. I don't think Greco taking too much time in that left back position, so keep an eye on that as we develop too. Again, that's a fair, as we mentioned earlier, able to take that ball in pressure on the space and turn and release these three balls through. Rukin plays this one back. This time the touch actually letting it down though and letting the Lions off the hook. Also looking to bring that one in, but no one with her. Scooped up by De Boer, moved out to Mancini, but that ball out for the teammate. Some touch loose. And Warren not able to. Probably one of the trickier things to do in football. The short throw in and the easy ball back to the one who trusted him. Surveys our options sensibly, keeps this one. retains possession. Quite this time around. Greco wants to take the space. Ooh, tried to play that one inside and lost the rest of the red as well. Hawks looking for options, but again, maybe taking a little bit too long. I think if the looks are on a one to make it probably, as we've already seen, the loose touch from Chow. So it's well read by Val. And her efforts to ensure she doesn't give the ball away, she just needs to give her a free kick in a really dangerous position. North Toronto well poised there. And so, good work from the North Toronto press. We talked earlier about them allowing Alliance to settle. So maybe when the defense is settled, North Toronto not necessarily looking to create transitions, but certainly looking to capitalize on any sort of broken field situations that occur. This was maybe a bit of overplaying from Hannah Chow, actually, that got them into this trouble. She had the simple ball back to her goalkeeper, Stewellis, but looked to take the touch and turn and maybe didn't see Bell over her shoulder. I've already seen Bell really chase her, so let's see how that develops over the course of the game as well. It was Matt Safaro, looks to get us restarted, floats the ball in, and this one away from an Alliance head, and he wasn't nearly looking to set this up. Able to do so. Good to keep on that one. We'll keep this moving. Rollins leads Webster out with the pass. And yeah, that goes right back to center back. Ooh, nice ball through the lines from Matsafella again. Turn and move. See how wide we're going to stay every occasion on that touchline. Once those 1v1s. Rollins in tussling with Gotham and giving away the free kick. And he will say again, North Toronto are likely happy to give away the free kick in the Alliance half rather than allowing the play to continue conceding the space behind them. Space and was looking for that run, and then the Greco had stepped up just a touch, which broke the defensive line. She's able to keep that one in, lays that one back, and yeah. So we saw that Ripon, the North Toronto Metro's wing back, number 12, has been looking to run down the line all half. Webster took it this time, and the Alliance United backline had gotten a little staggered. Valentina Greco had stepped up maybe a touch preemptively, which gave Rupin a great deal of space to run into. Greco had done well to get back and make the recovering run and get into a position to make the challenge, but persistence by Rupin, and then a cool head to find Matt Zaffaro. It's the player on the spot to just roll that one home. A very, very neat, calm finish leads North Toronto Nitros up 1-0. Isabella Matafera adds to her league-leading 7 goals, taking her up to 8 thus far in 5 games.
North Toronto goal in the 18th minute. Scored by number 19, Isabella Matafera.
Alliance, I'm sure, will be looking to get that fucking goal a little bit, because referee Dwight is just happy to let these teams play here today. Dice a touch with that pass to Webster, getting away with it. So the advantage of this three-player center, I was going to say, the advantage of this three-player center-back partner pairing, obviously the triumvirate, is that when Rollins, the central center-back, is stepping up the ball. She always has options, at least one option to her left and her right. And they'll move the ball out wide, force Alliance to compensate, which kind of moves the whole team around a little bit. And you can see that North Toronto, like, is lovely read by Jesse DeBoer. And the ball falls to Bell, but well met by Hannah Chow. Wonderful play from Courtney Cohn, but the assistant referee Forby has his flag up. They have two avenues really. Once the ball gets wide, they can either kind of force down the line as they did with the goal, or knock it back inside into the space to sort of catch the momentum of the line. It's going the wrong way, so to speak. Incredible piece of work from Courtney Cohn to really put in its spell out to Barra for that. Still in the game, only one down, plenty of football left to be played, but we're going to need to start getting that kick on the ball, building some possession of their own, still getting their game plan into effect. Because thus far, it's really been Toronto Nitro's running the show. You can see how they've got themselves into the second in that they were at this stage of the season. Strong. Plays that one back down the line and that ball in for Garza. Nearly fielded by Chuck. Oh, it's baffled as well. Deals with the bounce, but he wasn't able to step in and clean up. Now, you can see we've got two players chasing down Hannah Challenge, which plays this one sensibly. Back to Star Willis, who bumps it clear. Just a little stronger than Tristan Barnes this time around. Spread across the front wings, like one in each channel or each zone across the one runner forward in each zone across the width of the pitch. Gives them options every single time. So the three centre backs always have a pass to play. And as mentioned, with the three of them, they all look comfortable playing the ball and they're able to change the angle of the play, the ball, the pass coming in too. Farrah now with that ball in, nearly finding its way to Rollins. Actually, almost falling for Rukin too, but Rollins just about able to smuggle that one clear. Oliver again on hand to provide the defensive assist. Rukin up against Greco, beautifully to find a wee bit of space. Fighting to get to that loose ball, not really able to pull off a shot on target, or really a pass directed towards a player. Team, but a bit tenacity nonetheless. Good touch with four white shirts around there, really kind of hack it clear. Thank you. very crafty, sharp player. Brooklyn looking to touch that one in. Bell uses her strength, really able to keep that one behind, but gives up the free kick. I'm not sure Alliance may actually prefer the advantage in that instance. Played. Certainly seems as if the pattern of play here looks to get the ball into the feet or somewhere around their number 9, Laura Goss. And hope that she has the ability, as well, trust her ability, which we know she has, to hold the ball up and lay it off and find runners from the midfield or the wide players. As you can see on this near side of the battle. Is right up against the line when they are in possession. Inviting in an on-rushing defender and providing space. Elise Bell. Oh, yeah. Elise Bell. the cross across, going off a defender, hitting the underside of the bar, bouncing in play. Kyomi McCausland on hand to try and stumble that one through, but the Alliance defense just about hashing it clear. The following shot. Sailing over the bar, but again, noticed that the Leeds United defence really need to be much more disciplined or careful about when they try to put pressure off the ball. We've seen already that Isabella Mazzaferro is very, very capable of dropping in, receiving the ball with back to goal, turning and then finding the space that is left by any sort of vacating defenders. So, see if Alliance are alive to that, or whether they keep providing these open doors for North Toronto to walk through. Eventually whistling the play dead. There's maybe a couple of opportunities there. Referee Poletti to intervene, choosing only to do so on for an accidental handball on behalf of Jesse DeBoer, which as she went to ground. Gets dragged out to that wing back, just leaves a great deal of space for North Toronto to move into on these flanks here. And because they're playing with these three forwards, the Leafs now has had one battery of time and space and joy down this line. You really have to think the record needs a little bit of help either from winger or the midfield, as it looks like. Lines up possession. Oh, certainly not since they're close to a 4-3-3. this is sort of the story where the ball does get to the Alliance level 9. Moragas is much isolated. The longer we get around all these forward balls and the wide players, we have too wide a starting position with the ball. That's the only thing that hits the number 9. There's not really anybody there to win those secondary balls. Which leads to Alliance getting possession more often than not. Providing an easy route in, forcing it back out. And in this transition, Alliance may be rushing it a little bit. Chuck had the time to turn it back half, but chose to play it first time on the turn. Just a little bit wayward, so they step out of the lips there. Poor pass. Stepping it well to take the ball away from Chunk. He's eyeing up the run from the Novanach into the space that Webster vacated previously. Oh, it's good work from Greco to keep that one moving. Novanach being quite alive to it. Well, certainly when they should play a free kick in there somewhere. Well, I think I'll need to let them go. Good work there from David Beckett to win the challenge and keep that ball moving. Seems much more encouraging from Alliance. They've got North Toronto pinned back a little bit, able to play a little bit of football. Great idea. Now that through ball looking for the run of Parks, and Cusiana has a great starting position, nice and aggressive. Sweep up those. Centre back Hannah Chown earlier. Defensive or clearance way. Now we get to see one in an offensive manner. What a Rosa had done well. The flip on that worked for her, but she did well to pick up the loose ball. Got ahead of really nicely defined feet of Hannah Anderson, who's advancing in from midfield. Shot from Anderson, also far away from fantastic Sierra Cotillard, so certainly, yeah, the throw in from Hannah Chown. I think it's a loop that Alliance will be looking to take more often. It's time to pass. Not quite on the money. One option, she's got a big bubble around her, maybe we're looking for the ball. Well, finally, Leland has options. Maybe Chun Lady could have touched that one on.
Oh,
she's and in the opinion of the officiating staff, she's got more to play than ball on that challenge. Well, Red, she was alive to it. The W from Chung was a smart one. It did feel maybe she couldn't take that touch and play the pass to make sure that the ball had the pace on it. This is in a different spot now. good opportunity for Alliance to get something on this. Uruguay, I'm sure, will be looking to get aggressive with this one. Currently, actually, the part of coming through, which is, you have to say, something of a physical mismatch. suggesting that there is eligibility to stay on the field, even with the physio having been called for. The physio never actually made it to the player, so she's allowed to continue. Otherwise, you need to do so in possession. The antagonist the last few minutes, back in the second reaction once again. Nice ball through from Tafara, who we know has a great pace hunting down Beckett. Oh, the ball inside, well read. It was intended, of course, by Hannah Anderson, but well read by Courtney Poole, who was on it in a flash. Cleanly this time around.
As indicated, there will be 1 minute of added time.
We get to the end of the first half here. We only have 1 minute of a minimum of 1 minute of added time, as decided upon by the officiating staff. Breaking those lines nicely. Well fielded by Ovi Spell. Colton stepping inside. Well read, well marshaled by Mancini, who, despite initially being beaten by the flight of the ball, did well to get himself retained body possession. Side there. Oh, nearly finds Chung, who was the first to get her head through it. Well, certainly gives it the goal kick. And so first half, Cole brings to a close here. By referee Dwathi. We find ourselves, as mentioned, in a one goal game. North Toronto Nitros taking the lead in the 18th minute through league leading scorer Isabella Mazzaferro.
The score has climbed as North Toronto Nitros 1 and Lions United 0. Thurton came on from McCausland for North Toronto. And Vindemann has come on for Parks. We got $10. And Webster in attendance, but encouraging signs right from the off for the new layout for Alliance United.
does the move. That's a fair hand. Yeah, so we've seen a rejig in shape from Elias United. Let's see what this does for the second 45, if they're able to start mounting a more continued presence moving forward. And whether they're able to better match or better marshal the spaces that they intended to give them. They did previously the flat four that they had played with, was finding itself kind of overmatched with the three forwards and the two wing backs that went Toronto were pressing forward in that first half. So maybe this change is to kind of counteract those numbers and stop leaving those big spaces behind. So you can kind of see already that the centre backs are going player for player with those three forwards across that back line. Robin steps out. Webster keeps that one moving, brings all the way back for Cotillardi. Warren is looking to break those lines. It's well read. And a throw in for Alliance here tonight. Not looking for the long one this time around. That's Greco. Previously, it was going to be left back in that first half, because she's a right sided centre back, so kind of versatility there. Alliance number five. Jimmy finds Rollins. Rollins must be noted already performing well, even as a centre back. Team of the week for the second game week. That's very, again, dropping into that space, looking to play that ball there, finds Burton, keeps it moving for Bauer.
Oh,
that was a
falling
Lazzo Ferro. Oh, no. Oh,
man.
Get in. What a moment.
Stagolis
was, made the initial save.
There was one suspicion in the 45th minute. Exiting the match number 7.
Kiyomi
recalls entering the match number 20, Sarita 13.
Ability to drop deeper than make up that space with the late runs into the box and pick up on anything loose, but the last ranks of the Alliance United
substitution at the 45th minute, exiting the match number 13, Kristen Parks, entering the match number 20, Holt Wendell.
The Alliance United remained unscathed. That's actually the second goal man scramble that got through. Just play behind her. Back to clean up. She has Warren hot on her heels. Spot. needs some orange shirts, maybe a little closer to her. She's got nothing directly in the field. Breakfast touch looks to take the pass down. First one's alive. Greco's more on looking for the Dovin Ashes. Really is a hope rather than attention. Also looking for the is able to sneak it up while it's happening, like all kids are good to do. And net picks it up, keeps it moving for Mancini. Already in the opening offense of the second half, and so the new shape from the line is definitely a much better match than the one. And the back of Chiba was the rookie for that run of Chandra Lyons, who had taken the space that Mancini had left behind her, but. To it, just about able to cut that up. So, yeah, we have to after letting these throws from Vindemack go too, well, close to the half of the territory. We continue nonetheless. Forcing anything. Maybe asking herself a little bit too much and ran out of space. Monitored by Jennifer for whatever. Very, very well. And actually, it restarted. On the far side, and deemed it offside nonetheless. I think because there's a slight advantage playing with the red iron lines on the field, you always have like a built in VAR of sorts. Just about digging that one out. Oh, looking for the overlap. Looking, but hit her and player. Whatever is able to win the throw in. Nicely flighted throws from Chan as Gossett looks to battle with Webster. Clipping Gossett with that right at the referee running on play as he has been all game. To be fair to him, he's been consistent in his desire to allow the game to flow. Considered it really certainly a platform for Chow to launch it, but set off into it, play that one aside for Willow. So he's trying to bring her on in, not quite able to. Pounce on the right there, he looks to that's Farrell, but Beckett is there first. Duralis, in a clear bird. Loose balls in the middle of the field, perhaps, as a result. Who actually has Warren in the manner of space on his far side? She should chip that one. But actually, does. Warren could have attacked that space, but instead he could curl that one in. It's a really good one. Kind of catching Kotiari out, but I have to say, if the Alliance forward line maybe a little bit more alive, they could have capitalized on that. Kotiari was in two minds, really, as forces the issue with that one too. It's this game of really, I'm not gonna say opening up, but certainly getting end to end as we work our way into the second half. This change of shape from Alliance has really changed the form of the game. Again, this long ball from Stenalis finding its way all the way through. But North Toronto allowing it to bounce, which is not something I'm sure that they are. Coaching staff would be particularly pleased about. See if Alliance United can eventually capitalize on one of these long balls from the goalkeeper. That's a terrific ball from Ruben Neely, a great take, but he just loses it in her own feet. Release bell. See how that whole game so quick and sharp into those challenges to deny any sort of passage forwards down that line to the left hand side. A nice touch aside from Willever, finds, takes the space for herself, looking for Russell. Well met by Rollins. She had won it clearly, and referee Duati clearly feeling different. Asking to be attacked. able to cut that ball in. It's a Ferrer. It would have dropped. Ferrer's just not staying onside. It's a movement for Rukan. Rukan had Thurton behind her, but is happy to accept the corner under the challenge of Oliver. CIBC, a proud partner of League One. Gatorade, rehydrate, replenish, refuel. Degree inspiring the confidence to move. We'll see it over on that far side there. Plenty of movement. Because Oliver is maybe on the wrong end. A little bit too much. And then Macron work hard and laugh quite harder. I'm going to cut inside there while I'm going to come in, I guess, on that right foot. Get that free kick under the intentions of Perez. Ooh, that's a lovely ball across for Gosser. Isn't quite able to get the head on it, but they did instill some panic in the North Toronto defence. They seem pretty relieved to hear the referee's whistle go for the offside. For the first time in a while, that North Toronto defence looked a little panicked under the flight of that ball in from Oliver. The attack from Ross. Possessor, fighting well with Mancini. Mullen's almost backed into a bad spot, but very calmly and coolly plays that one. Mullen's keeping the pressure on high up the field here. Gosser, though, as we've seen, not quite able to turn that one into a teammate. Trying to look to break. Alliance were resolute. Across to Chung, who finds herself all alone and did well to settle the ball, but the attempt perhaps falling on her non-favored left foot. I didn't think it was a great idea at the time for Oliver to cut inside. I thought she should have maybe driven down the line, but the ball in deceived the entire North Toronto defense. And John found herself all on her own. Surprised by the amount of space and time that she had. She was able to bring the ball down, and the shot not really having the venom that she really would have wanted it, but it's a little tricky one for Cote d'Art to deal with. So we find ourselves with a corner which makes its way all the way across. And it's there! The corner floated all the way to the back post by Hannah Chown. My apologies. Wallover with the corner to Hannah Chown. The header from the Alliance centre back. Again, causing panic at the back. North Toronto running
the
into themselves.
The last winning goal in the 66th minute by number 4, Hannah Chown.
Stadium announcer has actually given it to Hannah Chown. To my eye, it looked like it was Hannah Anderson who had turned it in after it was initially repelled on the line. And Anderson was there to make sure, tuck that one home, to see how that ends up on the final stat sheet. But we do have a tied game. And you can see a lot of
Come on,
let's
go
for
a slide. Who's rapping this game? Alright.
With a roughness that perhaps is not particularly well received. Sean receiving the
correction. Goal was scored in the 66th minute by Alliance United's number 7, Hannah Anderson.
And Maria Mancini receiving the yellow card. 67. Give me, we don't have a score. So, I think it's to provide more context. So, my time I think it might be a touch off, but the broadcast time that you see at the top corner. Absolutely accurate. Get up! 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 Oh, that's a great turn inside. And Sean, and let's take the shot. Oh. The touch inside from Chelsea Chung looked like it was spinning in a way that was just impossible to attempt to control. So Holly Whelan, the advancing midfielder, simply decided to allow the spin to bounce, go with it, and take the shot from there. Great piece of play that... So you can see really working themselves into this game. They've changed the shape and just not rather have really gotten themselves back into this. I mean, both on the score sheet and in the play. North Toronto not finding the easy routes out from the back that they were in that first half. So really well in, and after a great run from Chelsea Chung. In this instance, she was watched the hot walk from Olivia Mancini that came all the way across with her. It's the movement of Chung is causing all kinds of issues. We've already seen her find herself free from oceans of time and space around her. The previous ball from Oliver. He's looking to loop that one over for Warren, finding Stavrolis. What hasn't been working as well for North Toronto this half? That's Ferris still dropping deep, and it's just the spaces behind the defense aren't there in the same way they were. You can see in the first half there were the four defenders going up against the five attacking players from North Toronto. There was always a misbalance, so balls played into the feet of Isabella Mazzaferro when she would drop deep and able to turn. It was more often than not a makes a yawning chasm really behind the defense that she was able to play the ball into. With the Lions changing shape and being able to go player for player across the back line, those wing backs, Amir Rukin and Emma Warren, Rukin in particular, aren't getting anywhere near the amount of joy that they were getting in that first half. And as a result, even the Lions midfield, they're reduced by a player, finding themselves in this game much more, getting more touches on the ball, being able to influence the game a great deal more. So we see a change here. Matt Zaffaro being replaced by
New Toronto substitution in the 72nd minute. Exiting the match number 19, Isabella Mezzaferro. Entering the match number 10, Madeline Panham Durston.
Stop it. Oh, Chelsea Chong with a really beautifully angled ball for Laura Gosser. The angle of that pass was so delicate and so perfectly chosen to provide Gosser with the time to make the run, get the shot away, but well met by Sierra Cotillard. Accept that gift. take Warren to chase him. Again, closely attended to by the back. Does well. Referee's watching, allows that to continue. He clears it right on the line. Well met by Lawns. Cody wanted Webster a little further out, but was able to find DeBoer. That's flipping that one over for 30 to chase. That's actually a lovely ball, but it's actually also very nice and delicate. Thank you, Rashad. Was looking for Perez, but the Alliance defensive line stepped up in unison and very, very good timing on their behalf this time around to catch the offside. As we see some more changes, so
Laura Gossett, who
running a pretty tricky, plowing a pretty lonely furrow up top, she was replaced.
The Toronto substitution in the 72nd minute, exiting the match number 12, Leila Rukin, exiting the match number 28, Sarah Flood. Alliance United substitution in the 77th minute, exiting the match number 9, Laura Goss, entering the match number 19, Leda Nathan.
Such maybe wide left her in two minds. That first touch from Perez maybe could have been driven back towards goal rather than maybe that touch was a bit too straight. Warren was never really an option. She was there more to, I think, occupy the defender, but the pass to Warren was actually very, very well covered by the retreating Alliance United defense. So, as I said, Perez maybe the first touch just didn't leave her with the best angle to take the shot on. She was playing it wide at the far post. You can see a disappointment, but actually that was the first time we saw a pattern of play that was similar to the first half for Toronto, whereby Pemba and Bastien, the number 10, were able to drop into that space just behind the two midfielders on Alliance's side. They had all the time in the world to turn, and just had two options on this right side, with Thurton advancing the same breakdown on the right touchline. Mr. DeBoer actually finds himself in possession, but keep that one moving. Doing a sensible thing. Keeps hold of the ball. He's certainly running a foul. And just for the blue, we're doing himself a yellow card. Off the other side of the North Toronto captain, and it seemed that the North Front connected took exception to this.
Yellow card issued to number 16, Jesse Duer, in the 81st minute.
Beckett, looking to float that one over. It's a tricky one when the free kick is that straight. You're not necessarily able to play the angle against the goalkeeper. You can see that Cotillard is happy to let that one just roll right through that. First involvement for Naheem. He's taken up the left attacking position. But briefly occupied by Dovinash, who actually is taking up the line. Over by Warren Nelson, who is the last. Strong on that chase, the throwing from Chell, providing a tempting win to chase down. Caught out for these throws, which have been verging on foul every single time she took them. Olivia Manchin is certainly no textbook example either, but the referee allowing things to carry on. This one high into the Toronto sky. Trying to drop this on the head of
Андрей, я
понимаю, как
это? Вот это брей. Это сумки. Большой черный сумки. Достаньте сумку, пожалуйста.
Это место для
себя. Да. Откройте там вдоль стенки. Есть батарея. Светлая батарея. Не, ближе к луку. Да. Сейчас мы будем менять батарею.
Very neat ball, turn and ball in from Flood. Just beyond the reach of
Warren. Я ничего не вижу на этом экранчике.
Благодарю. On the money. As this game winds down, we are tied at 1-1. Our goal scorer is being Isabella Manzaferro in the 18th minute and Hannah Anderson in the 66th. Both teams really pressing. We've had some good opportunities. There's a couple of goal line clearances for Alliance United. So yeah, Eden Mikarez maybe should have scored. Big good opportunity, clear chance. Just flop that one forward. All of his ball sort of fired into the thighs of the not an easy one to bring in. By the same token, we've seen a couple of good opportunities from the Lions. Maybe not quite as many clear ones, but there was definitely one from Chelsea Chong in the second half where she found herself all alone on the penalty box. Plenty of time, but could only let the shot go on her left foot. That's a little bit disguised more than Naheem. The Dolman actually pass inside was she'd shaped up for to play in Chong, but the reverse ball in for the runner Naheem. Excellent. Not a bad shot either, forcing a save out of Cotillard. On target, asking the questions. And now we'll see Hannah Chow with one of these long throws. by Rollins, but she does give up a corner. And what a terrible outcome for Alliance, as that is the route that their first goal came from. When Waller was able to meet the head of Hannah Chow at that back post, and then the ensuing melee that actually is where Alliance's goal had come from. It's sweeping up. Oh, they've gone the same route this time around, but met a little bit more readily. Although Beckett looking to keep that one alive. Gives up the free kick on Florida. Interesting. Literally the same route from 15 to 4. Get that header back into the mixer. Cause some issues. Trying to weave her way through the entire team. But gone a little early. Pendant is still down after that challenge. I'm sure it is still taxing. This game is coming to a close here, so these players have been running around in this for long enough, certainly to be feeling the effects. Forward, right wing back, and is now the centre forward, the false nine of sorts, so versatility there.
Therefore, the substitution of the 88th minute, exiting the match number 10, Madeline Penner Thurston, entering the match number 14, Quentin Tostelli.
They
just
so desired, but
the fourth official is in the game. There will be a minimum of 4 minutes on
that. It's not a bad ball in at all, but well received by the defense. Chelsea Chong wants options. Greco looking forward under pressure from Thurston, though. Advancing down the line, getting away from Warren. Hold off the challenge. Which gets us moving maybe a little quicker than perhaps her teammates wanted. Lara Chow was coming across to take that throw, but you know what? the ball in from Vinterbach that wins them a corner. So I'm sure they'll be okay with the end result here. So Leeds United actually, now the team really pressing for the winner as this game rolls to a close. Interesting, the seesaw of power we've had with this is North Toronto really had a lot of their own way in that first half. Maybe should have had a couple more than the one they got, maybe not ruining some of those misses, but Leeds United coming back, certainly looking like a much better team in this second half. Greco's hot on her heels, but cover well. Flood. Looking to feed into Burma. Cutting off those passing lanes. Anybody in particular. Launches this one forward from Naheem's chase, right on the heels and on the shoulders of Justavin. But this is an opportunity now for Alliance to make this field small. Hem in North Toronto. See if they can apply some pressure. This is a smart move from North Toronto to left up to the wing back, take the throw. She's looking for Thurton. The ball just kind of hooks that one clear. Soon. This is one comes to a close, but an engrossing affair. 1-1. I mean, a tie, I think, fair reflection of the game. 1-1, maybe. Not so much. Ooh, you know what? I might speak too soon. That's just brilliantly to kind of space. Center and pass just behind the run of the attacking player. Looks like quite on target. So there you go, that three blocking brings us to a close. 1-1 with North Toronto Nitro scoring early in the first half. Isabella Mazzaferro in the 18th minute.
The final score for today's match is North Toronto Nitro 1 and Alliance United 4. We sincerely thank you for your support and wish all the buzz out there a special happy birthday.
From a corner, leading this one to a 1-1 game. First time no problem having one, but remain undefeated, as do Alliance. This is a good team of the world, really trying to get their confidence to have a team this season on their hunt for a playoff spot. Thank you so much for joining us today. This week, in the week one Ontario Women's Premier Division, a 1-1-5 team, Alliance United, and North Toronto Nitro. Thank you so much. I'll see you soon.